Hello everyone, Rantools version 2.0 has just been released and it has got a lot of new updates, and in this video I will cover all of them. Also, I have got a giveaway announcement towards the end of this video, so please watch the video till the very end if you want to participate in the giveaway. And without wasting any more time, let's talk about what's new in this version of Rantools. So let's start with PCutter. In the last update I added advanced edge alignment, and in this update I have added vertex alignment feature. So now you can align the grid to any vertex by simply holding down Ctrl and right clicking near it, and you can draw cutters like these very easily. Also, there is a new face mirror option, so if I want to mirror a cutter across a face, I can do that very easily with this new version. All I have to do is select the axis and press the O key twice to set the mode to face, and this is super easy and really useful. Next, we have some updates for the modifier tools. So I have successfully integrated the synced modifiers add-on into Rantools. So now when adding a modifier preset, you can decide if you want to use synchronized modifiers. For that you have to hold down Ctrl and Shift. So let's try this bevel plus weighted normal as an example. And as you can see, all these modifiers are now synchronized, and you can control them using any of these objects by using the quick modifier adjust. Just like that. Let's also see an example of the active object feature, which sets the active object into the object field of all the modifiers. So if I want to shrink wrap all these planes onto this cube, I can select them all and last select the cube and add a shrink wrap modifier preset. And all these modifiers are now synchronized, so you can change the offset on all of them by using any of these objects. If you also have the sync modifiers add-on, you can simply desync any of these objects at any time. So if I desync it, it becomes independent. And these two are still dependent and synchronized. I have also redesigned the quick modifier adjust panel, so it only shows all the properties which you use very often and not any excess properties. It is much more nicer looking and much more cleaner, so it becomes very easy to use. Next, we have Rantools project settings. So in the previous version, if anyone was using the power save add-on, which repeatedly saves the blend file and increments the name every time, Rantools would create a different folder for all the versions of the blend file. But this problem has been solved with this new Rantools project setting feature. So you can press Shift plus I, and here you can set your project up once and for all. So let's name the project test project and hit the setup project, and it will automatically set up a folder with that name and create a texture and render folder inside that, which will remain the same for any version of the blend file. And you can open this folder up by holding down Alt and clicking this. So all your blend files will go here. All your renders will go here, and all the textures you bake using that bake tool option in the Rantools will go here. So this is a pretty cool feature. Also, if the project is a new project and it has not been saved, pressing Ctrl plus S will also bring up the project information panel, so you can quickly set up your new projects very easily. And that is basically it for this feature. Next, we have some updates for the preferences. So first of all, the UI of the preferences has been improved. Now all the settings are categorized under different sections. You can also check for Rantools update right from the preferences by using this button, and if a new update is available, it will be shown right here. You can now also disable any of these panels if you want. So for example, if you don't want to use the backup manager panel, you can simply go to manage panels and disable it and enable it back whenever you want. All the preferences of Rantools are now saved into a file, so every time you update Rantools, you don't have to load them up one by one, they will be loaded up automatically. You will have to do it one last time after this update, but after that it will be all automatic. And that is it for the preferences part. So those were all the big updates, and for some smaller updates you can check out the changelog in the description below. And now let's talk about the giveaway. So I am giving away a free copy of Rantools Complete. The participation rules for the giveaway are pretty simple. All you have to do is like the video, subscribe to the channel, and in the comment section tell me which of these toolkits you find the most useful. It could be PCutter, Bake Tools, Curve Tools, Material Tools, Modifier Tools, or Batch Rendering, or whatever. And I'll choose one of you randomly to send a free copy of Rantools. And with that, we come to the end of this video. The links for the add-on, as always, are in the description below. So go check them out if you find the add-on interesting. And I'll see you in the next one.